42 looking for group posts already. But then again, yeah, this is probably from different countries around the world. It's probably available now.
I don't think people do that or stuff does that anymore. I think now they do it. It's midnight Eastern, so it's 10 o'clock over there.
No, when I just looked it up, it says available midnight during your local time.
There's a lot that don't do that.
And like,
baseball didn't do that.
It shows the U.S. It says available local at midnight to your time. Europe says available at some kind of time, CET, whatever that is. So
probably
I have no idea.
Game Pass. No, I take that back, because baseball was game.
I'm not seeing it yet.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's just going to be the whole, what do you call it, probably have to wait till midnight thing and see if it pops up anywhere.
Yeah, I guess I'll wait. No problem. What time is it? 2 more hours. My
yeah,
end.
It's not bad.
But you'll be in bed.
I don't have to be in work till 9 tomorrow.
Somebody just asked Adriana Chechik how her neck is now. You know you're a dirty slut when not only you've got 3 dicks in your ass at the same time, but you actually like break your neck having sex.
That would be bad.
Wait, she did that?
What, was she taking it dog style and she,
no.
He pushed too
the,
hard and...
No, like the pretzel.
Really? Yes.
Can you imagine being the guy? Like, ew, what was that? I broke her.
Yeah, the guy's like, ew, what the fuck was that noise? And you're just still going and then she's just not responding.
Okay.
It's like, ew.
First thing is, he's like, did I break my dick? No, I'm good. And then he just looks at her, like, passed out.
She's, like, all crippled, like, Rick, like Morty when he falls off the cliff and he didn't turn on his boots.
Yeah.
Oh, my
laser
God.
All, like, deformed.
This fucking reminds me of something that Jay told me a couple of years ago. Their old house, they had a windowsill above the bed. And, they put something on the windowsill, and he was like, yeah, I had Marissa doggy in the bed to hit the wall, and whatever was on the windowsill fell and hit her on the back of the head and put a lump on her head.
Wait, he was giving it to her doggy?
Yeah, oh he said God. They had something on the windowsill, and the bed hit the windowsill, and whatever was on the sill fell and hit her in the head.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
So it's pretty cool. So you have some VR training to do. It like some different things that like kind of teach you how to play.
Mm-hmm.
Then as you level up, you unlock different places in the world to go. So you start off with New York City, then you go to San Francisco, then you got Alaska, and somewhere out in the desert. Then as you level up even more after that, there's like 2 more places to go and like the missions are kind of cool. There's like 3 areas. They get harder as you go through. Each place has its own.
Hey, folks, it's
do.
The coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team. Let's send it down to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis for the call.
We start this challenge in the 4th quarter, and only 1 minute is left on the clock. You're up by 2 points. Your opponent has the ball on their 20-yard line. As we get set here, 1st and 10. And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. And I think the Chiefs have it. They do. Well done. You've defeated this ultimate challenge. Now, if there are stars still available, you can always replay the challenge again. Otherwise, it's time to move on to the next one.
That's not that ugly. Really? That's considered one of the most ugly?
What's that?
Bad. No, I was just curious. I did a Google search. According, this is from NHL.com, a subreddit, saying, what is the top worst NHL logos in NHL history? And they have this Oilers one. I don't know if you remember this one, where it was like it looked like a gear. It was gray with a drop of oil going diagonal.
North Star's one.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I didn't think those were that bad. They weren't great, but...
I know, that's on the list.
The North Star.
And even this one, I didn't think this one was that ugly. This was the, you remember the original third jerseys for the Nashville Predators? It was the saber-tooth tiger. It looked like it was like 3D. It was like coming out of the...
Hey, folks, it's the coach here. Welcome back for another exciting matchup in Madden Ultimate Team. Let's get back to Brandon and Charles for the call.
Coach, we will begin this challenge in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining. You have a three-point lead. You've got the ball on your own 25-yard line. First and short. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
40 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
As I take a look at the clock, I realize that this drive has eaten up a good portion of the fourth quarter already. Got to tell you, partner, when you're trying to salt away a game, this is exactly what it's supposed to look like.
Now they'll throw with Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And this is taken in at the 5. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 47 yards. Nicely done. Another one up, another one down. Keep grinding and keep racking up those wins. As his guy.
Lightning's third jersey from 96. Look that up. Tell me that's not the most hideous thing you've ever saw.
Is the White Sox.
What, the baby blue ones? I tell you what, I think if I ever saw somebody selling one of these jerseys, I would just buy it because it's fucking hideous.
The Lightning third jersey, I'm looking it up right now. Wait, just came. Oh my god.
I have a Falco jersey.
Yeah, what is that?
Hey everybody, thanks for joining us today. I'm the coach, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. Let's join this one already in progress. Here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We will begin this challenge in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining. Tie game 7-7. Your opponent has the ball on their 20-yard line. First and long. And just like that, another ultimate challenge has been defeated. Savor the victory, if only for a moment, because you know there's always another challenge right around the corner.
Let's add some waves on the bottom. And then, yeah, we'll put the logo in the mid. Yeah, dude, this is... That is pretty... Look, it looks like a lacrosse jersey. Like, yeah, that is bad.
I think the Chiefs' black jerseys are pretty ugly, but I wish they would do it.
Like, none of the designs even, it doesn't even, yeah, that is an ugly, yeah, this is pretty ugly. Now, this is just a clusterfuck of, like, different, so much shit going on the jersey.
Like you the coach here, and welcome to this ultimate challenge. Sit back and relax. You're in for a real treat with this matchup. Now let's hand it off to Brandon and Charles as we jump straight into the action.
Coach, we will begin this challenge in the third quarter with 3 minutes remaining. You're trailing by 4, but you're in the red zone. First and short, 57 yards on the ground for him so far.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
Not too many more ideal situations at 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Odell Beckham, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the 3rd quarter. Nice job there getting the win. Next up, another challenge, of course.
Literally, like, well, just like complete yellow and you have the red numbers. I think that would...
I think it's white.
Oh, red.
Just a real thin red, like, piping. So they've never worn either one. They've only worn white and red.
Actually, now that I think about it, it kind of reminds me of the creamsicle jerseys of the Buccaneers. Is it like that,
yes,
but just yellow?
Yeah,
like, oh, okay. There you go.
What the fuck is this? They're invisible? Oh boy.
Invisible tickers? Oh boy.
No, these guys are, I'm fighting like new enemies. These guys are invisible, then there's tickers. Wrenches on turns.
Hey everybody, welcome. It's the coach with you here today for another edition of Madden Ultimate Team. Taking you the rest of the way, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Brandon.
This challenge starts in the 4th quarter with just 30 seconds remaining. You're trailing by 2 points, but you're down to your opponent's 10. 1st and goal. Little razzle. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the 4th.
Wow. Wow.
All right, you did it. You got the win. Congratulations. Keep that momentum going and tackle that next challenge.
I'm not even fucking kidding.
I know my first buy if I ever hit the Powerball.
Wait. Let me get the details. Why is this one?
Well,
oh,
is it like a game used one or something?
It's assigned.
Okay. There was nobody on that team in 96 to sign that to make that worth 97 million or 2 million.
It's signed by Sicarelli.
Exactly. Who's that?
Exactly. I don't even know. I never heard of
player. I remember him. And
Sicarelli, number 22.
There's Zuccarello, who's
that's
who playing currently.
No, then that's not it. It was somebody in hits.
I'm gonna Google him right now. I don't think I've ever heard of a player named Sicarelli. Let's see, Lightning.
Yeah, that sounds like it starts with an S, not a Z.
With a C.
Well, damn, definitely wrong.
On Wikipedia, where the fuck is he? Here we go. Dino Sicarelli. Canadian player.
Dino
played 19 seasons in the NHL. He played for the... Minnesota North Stars, then was traded to the Tampa Bay Lightning. He played for the Detroit Red Wings for a season.
Yeah, what year was that?
I don't know. I'm looking.
Oh, you know.
Hello, and welcome to this Madden Ultimate Team Showdown. I'm your host, the coach. To finish this out, here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, we start this challenge off in the 1st quarter with 3 minutes remaining. We're still without a score, tied at 0. You've got the ball on your own 25-yard line, and it's 1st and 10. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion, and to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Tyreek Hill, 75 yards. And on just two plays have taken the lead. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here comes the Ravens on offense and the man in charge from Louisville, the former MVP, Lamar Jackson. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's Jackson. Rush coming and he's taken down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack and it brings up second. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson, room here to run. And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. A big play there on the catch and run. That was so well timed. Just a perfect throw on the slam.
Hit him on the move, didn't he? Now he's going against the grain of the defenders coming over to try and stop him. That allowed for that additional yardage downfield.
And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
Well, every now and then we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your best ability is often your availability. And this is an extremely durable kid coming out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to break big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore, an absolute perfect fit.
On third down, Jackson from right side is complete to Andrews, his tight end. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. That'll give him 8 that time, and it'll be fourth down.
I thought maybe when he caught, he'd have a good chance of getting that first down, but that's a nice job of holding him up and preventing him from getting to the sticks.
And brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. First and goal, they'll try the option left. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Inside handoff here to Ricard. And he'll take this one inside the 10 down to the 8. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on third and goal. Now it's Jackson. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Tucker's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there, because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things, because if you don't score, you potentially open the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He only has a single solo carry, 1. Numero uno, second quarter. They need to get in the ball more, don't they?
I'm not the greatest statistician in the world.
Yeah, you are.
But a back like that with only one carry kind of takes me back to college in the classroom. Not enough evidence to declare what you should do the rest of the game. Give him the ball some more and find out.
Will they incorporate him? We'll find out. Meanwhile, Burrow's throw caught by Sanders. And down inside the 10 at the 9. A big play there on the catch and run.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focus, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Priest Holmes, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals add on to their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder, puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. On second and 11 now, Jackson. He'll check this down to Dobbins out of the backfield. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. First down now, but that clock rolling. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Jack Youngblood. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Again, Jackson will keep it. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 3 yards on the keeper, and it's fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. Good work bringing that one back as he picks up about 16 on the return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive.
And with only 9 seconds remaining, but not much time, we'll see how they play this.
And going deep for Hill. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And for a Cincinnati score. Tyreek Hill in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bengals will extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead is up to 18 now.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away.
Short, short kick. One of the up middle take it down. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter, here we go. The Ravens set to receive the football, trailing here as we resume action in the third quarter. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now it's Jackson. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away, not intercepted.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. Now Jackson, rolling to his left. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Jack Youngblood, able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Here's Sam Cook now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good.
Hardman on the return.
That's a 43-yard punt, aided as well by a loss on the return.
Here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Now they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought process going into it is, hey, if you have to be methodical, go ahead and do that. But what you really want are a couple of big plays. Eat up chunks of yardage and cut down the number of times you have to snap the football.
They'll keep it on the ground. Holmes, and he works it across the 25 before being tackled.
I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run, and that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. A former rushing champ, a three-time All-Pro, it's Priest Holmes. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now to this point.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. We have played three quarters. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Back now in Cincinnati on second down now. It's Holmes. It's the Bengals in possession of the football and in possession of the lead as well as we start the fourth.
Heavy set out there on third and one.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
And he's going to be down close to a first down at the Ravens 26. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get your reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away.
And he is going to have a Bengals first down, and comfortably so, as he gets five there on third and a yard. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll go down as a gain of six, and it'll make it second down. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
And he's brought down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Now one final throw here is incomplete, and that is how this one will come to an end. And that'll just about do it for us in this one. You've notched another win, and the next challenge awaits.
Kills a secondary weapon, 15 kills total, okay.
Where's the third weapon? Tell me when you want to play PUBG. I only have to play one game.
Was it a YouTube video?
Yeah, it's a series. It's a series.
Machinima. Okay.
You can kill somebody because their leg is sticking through the wall. Like, should I kill him? He's like, no, that's fucked up. That's the game's fault. He's like, well, that's not my fault. He's like, don't stick that close to the wall. You see Doc's return to Fortnite?
No.
They crouch behind a box, and he goes to throw a grenade, and it clearly looks like he's throwing it over top, but he throws two grenades, and they land right next to him. And he just kind of looks over it, and just looks at the screen, like... then he blows up. Tim's like, I've got you to... Okay. Burger?
Yep. Shit's about to get interesting.
That was one of the good achievements. Duke Nukem.
What, throw a shit at somebody?
No, you had to steal a pile of shit out of a toilet, and the achievement was called Turd Burger. It was like the only good thing of that game, too. After waiting 10 years for that. See, there's a Wolverine video game coming out.
Nope.
Only for PlayStation. Probably another third-person RPG.
$20 billion.
I'm sure Sony will be fine.
Let me double check. I thought it was billion. Let me see.
I think my favorite thing that I heard is that EA wanted to buy Activision. Yeah. And I was like, EA can't even fucking handle sports games.
That's what I'm saying.
Imagine them trying to handle hacking.
No, they can't even control their response to glitch goals in NHL.
I was waiting for you.
Better. They have that stupid play in Madden where it's like all the linemen like chop the line and everyone just fell.
Yep, $20 billion. Once the Microsoft purchase was announced of Activision, their stocks dropped $20 billion after the announcement.
Sure, Sony will be fine.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see what they do. What's their next move? Because they're still getting a lot of...
Make better games?
People saying, like, you know, this is really more than bad because they still haven't released a PS5 exclusive game yet.
Yeah, they did.
Which one?
Spider-Man? Demon's Souls?
Spider-Man was PS4. The PS5 game.
No. Isn't Miles PS5?
No.
Well, I know Demon's Souls is a PS5.
No, Spider-Man was 4.
Spider-Man was 4. All they did is they ported
it.
What do you call it? Like a PlayStation.
Well, I know Demon's Souls is exclusive.
Well, I've checked there. They said that there's not an exclusive PS5 game yet. They haven't even released one yet.
Unless they don't count that because it was made on PS3, but... It's definitely exclusive, because it's one of the only reasons I want to get that before Series X.
Well, yeah, okay then, but I'm just saying, like, I actually looked this up because I was curious.
I understand. I'm saying what they are saying, their qualifications are splitting hairs by whatever they're basing that. because you can't get Demon Souls unless it's on PS3.
Hey folks, I'm your host, the coach. It's game time. It's Ultimate Team. It doesn't get any better than this.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next
Xbox
drive.
Ruined Halo and Gears of War. I'm not excited for them having control over Call of Duty and Overwatch.
There's no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Man, I'm bored with Paul.
Here's Holmes.
It wasn't for zombies.
Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends
same thing
as
that,
the game progresses.
Same thing that Squaresoft did, or Square Enix, whatever the fuck they go by now. They refused to ever make the remake of Final Fantasy VII until they were desperate. That they never needed. Then once 15 was done, they're like, okay, we'll make it.
To pick up key first downs and big runs.
That and they knew how much work is made.
Yards the tally on that
the original on PS3
run.
Took three, or on PS1 took three discs. I can't imagine what it was like now. And
only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third.
Even Lost Odyssey, I downloaded that a couple years ago when it was free, and it was like 40 gigs, and that's an Xbox 360. What the hell? That was four discs.
Wide open for an offense partner.
Nice job, hold him to one after that 8-yard pickup.
Final Fantasy 8 was four discs as well.
Scoreless after one.
I don't know about nine.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Hands it off out of the gun. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
No, I said they suck when they get control of everything.
Keep them short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively,
they bought Gears from Epic. They bought Halo from Bungie. And then both of the series just sucked afterwards.
Get my defense off the field.
And
Halo was in the toilet. I think people are only getting excited about it now because it's been so long.
The touchdown pass, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon.
I don't think so, but I think that people that are just loving it are the ones that are diehard that just haven't had it.
So that drive goes 8 plays, and it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt.
With yours.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men.
And they kind of tried to do that with yours as well. You had a fucking.
This offense finding its legs.
And they made that story all progressive too. Let's talk about Kate. Okay, what do you care?
Jackson. This one caught by his tight end Andrews. 5 yards
playing DVD.
The catch there brings up second down. Here's Jackson to throw. That's to Cook out of the backfield. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. From the gun, Jackson.
Passing Mass Effect 1 through 3 and Bud Drama, right?
First down and more for. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Chiefs.
They need to remake Anthem.
That's where the return stops. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to
yeah, them
the
peeling off Cortana
you.
Was a mistake,
what
too.
Position you play, you've got to take care of the rock. Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down.
Or whatever they call the brute.
Looking for Sanders here on the deep ball. He's got it. Touchdown, Chiefs. Emmanuel Sanders. As time expires.
in the first half. And the Chiefs will extend their lead on the final play of the half.
I mean, a lot of the Halo games were recently beat. I don't remember how many of them. I'm like, it seems like the exact same thing I was just doing.
Or return to challenges to receive your reward.
Game Pass.
Oh, yeah. Game Pass,
yeah.
I did see where people are pushing for a Master Chiefs game. The Fuel did something too, and I saw it, and I'm like, that's a...
The Fuel put up a map.
Yeah, that's right.
It's your new King of the Hill map.
Yeah, and it was like the beta map or whatever.
I mean, it sucks though.
Oh, they put Reinhardt in a Cowboys jersey?
Any of the original Halo campaigns, like, you were going to something completely different.
No, it wasn't. All those maps seemed identical. I'm going in a circle. I'm inside this building. I'm going in a circle the other direction.